Hello everyone, my name is Lukas Lux and I'd like to welcome you to my video presentation. I'd like to talk about the change detection of the accepted rock slope failure of the mountain Hochvogel based on the M332 distances in photogrammetric point clouds. Here we see different pictures of the Hochvogel, which is located in the Alps on the border between Austria and Germany. The summit of the Hochvogel is characterized by a big crevasse which divides the summit into a stable and an unstable part. The unstable part is in danger of collapse and there is the risk that it will fall into the valley. From geological measurement, we know that the unstable part is moving with a magnitude of 2.5 millimeter per month. To monitor this movement, a large set of sensors was installed at the top of the summit. In this presentation, I want to talk about the photogrammetric observation which we have carried out. The aim of the work is to achieve an aerial and precise deformation and change analysis. The results from this can be used to classify the type of the landslide, if it's sliding, falling, or tumbling, or to estimate the total mass movement of the rockfall. First, we need a 3D reconstruction of the region of interest. Therefore, we use the workflow displayed on this slide. First, we capture some image of the crevasse. With this overlapping image sequence, we are doing a bundle adjustment to estimate the camera position. Then we're doing a dense reconstruction using a global, semi-global matching algorithm. Our image sequences are generated in two different ways. The first one is the so-called double edge configuration. In those images, we see both edges of the crevasse. On the stable one, place some ground control points, so these images can be used to registrate the data. The second one is called crevasse configuration, where we tried to look as deep as possible into the crevasse. For the change detection, we are using the M332 distances to compare the point cloud from different epochs. From a local neighborhood, key points are estimated. Then these points are projected along the normal vectors into the second point cloud. The distance between the original and the projected key point is the distance we are looking for. For each key point, also, a noise estimation is done on that base of the neighboring points. So the quality of the calculated distances can be considered, and we can decide whether an observed change is significant or not. To compare two point sets, they must be registrated. We do this co-registration in two different ways. First, we use ground control points. To this aim, we placed targets over the stable part of the summit. The coordinates of these points were determined with GNSS receivers and total stations. Because placing and observing these ground control points is a very time-consuming step, we used a second method. Therefore, we just use the points of the stable parts of the calculated and calculate the registration by using the ICP algorithm. At first, we will registrate the point sets by manually selecting equal points in both sets. Then we were calculating the M32 distances between the two point sets. We remove the points with the highest values and run the ICP with the remaining points. Then we repeat this step until the calculated distances are below a threshold. In our experiments, we used a terrestrial platform, a camera mounted on the stick, which you can see on the picture, to capture the image of the crevasse. For the registration, we have placed several ground control points and tie points along the crevasse. We did three measurement campaigns in 2018, 2019, and 2021. The date from 2018 served as a reference data set. Each data set consists of 16 million points and have a resolution of around about 3 millimeters. Now we're coming to our obtained results. First, we want to have a look of large changes. In these figures, all points with the M3C2 distance greater than 10 centimeters are marked in purple. We assume that the changes correspond to erosion effects. In the cutout on the right, you can see an example of a big boulder that has fallen down between 2019 and 2021. In the below figure, the corresponding points are marked in purple. Furthermore, if we compare the results from 2019 to 2021, we can also detect that the affected areas are expanding with time. Now we want to take a closer look at the moving parts of the crevice. In the figure at the bottom, you see the distance between 2080 and 2019. When we are looking at the histogram of the differences, we can detect two main peaks, one by minus 1.6 centimeter and one by minus 0.8 centimeters. The smaller peak corresponds to horizontal surfaces and the bigger one to vertical areas. The same result can be seen for the data set of 2021. Here, also two peaks occur in the histogram. In different to the previous one, the order of the magnitude is much higher. It's minus 6.1 centimeter and minus 1.8 centimeters. But again, the peak corresponding to horizontal and vertical surfaces, like you can extract from the blue and green areas in the figure. All in all, it can be seen that the wall of the crack is moving in the direction of the valley. To evaluate our results, we compare our method with the result of single marked points. These points were installed on the unstable side of the crevice. For each data set, the position of the point we are calculated photogrammetrically from the results of bundle adjustment. The difference of the points from 2080 and 2021 are displayed in the figure. For all these differences, we performed a significant test, which shows that all points moved significantly. When we compare the results with the results from the M332 distances, we can detect that the magnitude and the direction of the movement are matching. Finally, let's compare the results of the registration method. In the previous results, the point cloud from the different years were co-registration with the help of ground control points. Now we registrate the points with the ICP algorithm and compare the resulting point cloud with the M332 distances. The mean of these distances are only 1 millimeter, but when we are looking at the distances here in the upper image, you can see that the point cloud is a bit squared. On the right side of the point, the distances are much higher. The same pattern occurs when we are looking at the results from the significant analysis. The red points correspond to areas with a significant difference. The result shows that the ICP only partly provides equivalent results. One of the reasons for this could be that the point on the stable part are not equally distributed over the crevice. Instead, most of the points are located on the right side, so the registration is influenced by this. To come to an end, in this presentation, we have shown a workflow for the monitoring of alpine rock slope failure. We saw that the movement pattern at the Hochvogel from 2080 to 2090 continue in the new data from 2021. The M3C2 distances provide comparable results to results of market targets. ICP only partly provides the same results compared to the registration with ground control points. There are still some unsolved tasks. For example, the M3C2 distances only observe changes along the direction of the local normal. So no 3D motion vector can be calculated. It's also not possible to track individual objects. So in the future, we want to segmentate the point cloud into parts with the same movements, and then to be and track objects with the same movement over the time. Thank you for your attention.